your network is good and you properly presented yourself for the interviewer. And with respect to just the coding knowledge, I will speak in this. So you need to check, or you need to be more precise in learning about the detailed things rather than just going with the general topics. Okay,
Okay.
because when I'm asking you about logins, you don't know what are the different type of logins and how they are working and what exactly will you do when there is an application failure, how will you maintain the logs and all. Because when the process is completed and when the audit is being done, they will definitely ask you how are you maintaining the logs and what exactly the logging mechanism is. So that you need to definitely take care. And
Okay,
let's
continue.
let me complete, then we'll go. So you should definitely know about the exception handling, like what is the different exception handlings do we have. If we can handle the exception in such a way that the process runs continuously even if there is an exception, maybe we need to check exactly how RE framework works. And you also need to go into specifics. Like I have said, you are aware of UiPath. I completely understood that, and you know the topics basically, and how to configure things and how to do the process. That is good enough for you. But if you go into the next step, and if you want to take through into the next lead, you definitely need to go into the roots, like how exactly things are happening and what is the exact requirement for the solution, rather than just going and saying that, okay, this is my solution and this is the inputs that I've got and I build this. You also need to see what are the positives and negatives of creating this particular automation. Is it really necessary to create an automation with UiPath, or can we do this with any other tool? Maybe you're saying that there is a PowerShell command that you're currently writing. So let's say that with that PowerShell command, instead of rewriting with the UiPath script, because again, if you want to use a UiPath script, you need to install UiPath in that particular machine. Again, the person who is running that UiPath should know something about UiPath and how it runs. Maybe can we write it directly using PowerShell script? Okay, so robotic process automation is not just about UiPath, or it's not just about automation anywhere. It's about how we are reducing our manual effort and how we are making sure that the bot exactly does our work and we are not working for the bot. The bot really works for us and gives out some output externally. So yes, so this is what I can give you the feedback. So you are good on the basic part. And I will really wish you all the best and continue to keep learning and create more projects, because as you continue building the projects, that's where you will get to know what are the different problems that you will face. Maybe in this particular project, you didn't find any issues. Maybe you have cleared something. But when you're doing the next project with the same concept, then the same concept may not work in the next project. The exact thing that you need to do is you need to go back and see why exactly things are failing and how you need to go back and correctly make sure that things are working. And when we are creating a robotic process automation in a particular organization, the most of the bots right now, let's say that there are 100 processes to be automated, and when we start the bot and we complete the first bot, okay, we'll be in a josh that okay, the first bot is success, let's go in hurry and complete the remaining bots. But as we continue and as we add more into that bot, the complexity gets increases. Now instead of maintaining or seeing the business, we are actually maintaining the bots, so we are actually working for the robots that we have actually built to reduce our work. So these are the things, like in generic you should have to really understand the concept of robotic process automation and to work. Okay. Okay.
We're coming to the types of logging. You mean that info, error, the
Exactly.
types?
Exactly. So you need to see how exactly you need to configure them and when you should configure them. Not everything should be configured with info. Not everything should be configured with error.
Error or trace.
Yeah, error or trace or fatal. So that you need to see. And when asking the question, if the question is not proper enough, you can ask back that, can you please elaborate the question? I didn't understand the question. That can be done. Okay.
Yeah, sure. Yeah, thank
How did you feel about this interview? And
this was actually good. Like you have asked real-time questions. Like you asked me to show my robots, and you asked me to do some editing and making it to run again. And a few questions are really interesting. Like abundant, you got the answer from me with your way of showing me the answer.
Okay.
Like I really didn't know in the first point what was the answer can be, but when you asked me to show what are the status that was there, then I have thought, okay, abundant can be the answer for the question that you have asked previously. So that was a very good way of yours to finding the path of the answer. So yeah, it was helpful actually, because I got to know that I have to go little deep, digging deep in the concepts, and I have to create projects so that I can have little good practical knowledge apart from the project knowledge. Yeah, it was good. It is helpful. Yeah, I really thank you for that.
Okay, thank you so much, Harshni. And Harshni, this is not a paid service, so I'm just checking how good we are exactly in, so I can learn from you and you can learn from me. And this session will be recorded online. Not maybe if there is any company thing that you have said, I will edit it, and I'll make sure that the identity is kept safe, and it will be there in YouTube. So how exactly you can use this interview is maybe instead of checking or sending your resume alone, make sure that your presentation is also visible to others, because when you're doing something, others or someone who is really interested in knowing how exactly you're working or to assign work for you, they need to know what exactly you know. Even in the interview, when we are doing a face-to-face interview, maybe in the technical discussion, we may exactly ask some questions that you cannot answer. But the real thing is, when an interview is happening, we'll hire or an interviewer will see what exactly you can do rather than seeing what exactly you cannot do. Okay, so we'll hire you based on what exactly you can do. So keep up the work and make sure, I think you will be in success for sure.
Yeah, one more thing. I want to confirm my positive and negatives. So the first thing is I have to edit my resume based on the duties or the responsibilities that I have worked on each and every project. So I have to edit my resume, and I have to, you know, go very deep into the even the basic stuff to understand the exact activity of that. And yeah, so these are the changes that I have to do. Right. So can you tell what can be the positives of mine when I gave this interview?
So, like I have said, you presented yourself well.
Okay.
You are up to the point. Okay, you made yourself ready for the interview, made sure that there are no disturbances. See, these are the things that normally people will forget in a longer run, but that really creates an impact over to an interviewer as well. And when you are saying something, you know that things will work there like this, and you're confident enough in showing that these are things. So the real question that I have asked you regarding that Excel scope is, I also know that there is, if we don't have the Microsoft activated, then we will find an error or the bot will throw an error. So that is the reason I have asked you to run it and show. Maybe it worked for you. I will also check myself with that, but that's fine. Okay.
Thank
Thank
you.
you so much, Harshni. Bye. Great. Nice talking to you.
Yeah, same here.